So, good morning, everyone. I, Ashish, on the behalf of my team, Mr. Ram Nishwin, Dr. Shashank Alekhya, is going to present the best application, which is peak shaving. So this is the collective work that we have done. So before directly jumping onto the topic, let me give you a background that why BSS in India has to become an integral part of distribution planning. So first of all, there is a increase in demand with changing demand patterns, and the EVs and solar rooftop is going to push this envelope further. When I say solar rooftop, I mean when you have a variable generating source at the consumption end, then your net demand is going to become more variable. When you talk about EVs, I mean your total load at the distribution end is going to increase. Grid discipline is also increasing. If you look at the DSM-4th amendments, penalties are increasing. If you look at the amendments at national tariff policy, they are making it must to provide 24/7 continuous supply by DISCOMs. If it is not done, they will be penalized. So all this is putting adversity towards the distribution system operators. So they have to adopt various measures such as forecasting, demand side management, maybe batteries and other options as a part of their distribution planning. That has to be there. So if we look at the batteries as a part of distribution planning, these are the few applications which we have listed. If you look at distribution transformer level, these are the applications. At feeder level, this is the application. At substation level, these are the applications. So generally, it is believed that we can stack benefits when we talk about battery energy storage systems. But how far you can build that stack before it falls down, it depends, right? So in this particular study, we will be talking about the augmentation deferral of distribution transformer, you can call it peak shaving or overload management, using batteries. So distribution transformers basically remain overloaded in very few months, mainly summer months due to AC loads, right? So BESS installed at secondary side of DT can charge during underloading instances and discharge during overload instances, keeping the loading on the distribution transformer linear or distributed or uniform. So this way, it will lead to increase in the life of DT, and it will also defer the investments that will only be there for like 2 months, summer months. So this is the application. This slide talks about scope of study. So the first and the most basic part of this study was to assess the viability of BSS at the LV side of DT. This not only included the physical site inspection, analysis of load data, but also various other aspects which are practical aspects of the utility. Once we have finalized the DT, we have finalized the location, then we can move up to designing the control logic algorithm, how we are planning BSS to operate, what would be the shave level is mentioned by David. And once we have arrived to a control logic algorithm, we can come up to a size of BSS. So once we have size, we can also evaluate the economic viability of BSS. Is there any economic sense of using BSS on secondary side of DT at this point of time at the present cost? So the objective of this study is to understand how BESS can be integrated to secondary side of DT to manage its overload, and what are the benefits associated with this application? Can we quantify them? Is it financially viable? These are the activities that we will be talking in the slides. First one is detailed load analysis of the DT. We will we analyze the DT load data for 3 years on half-hour interval. Then control logic algorithm development, then BSS sizing, and then cost-benefit analysis. So when we talk about best sizing, so first of all, the time series data for the 3 years was analyzed, and the definition of overloading of DT was taken from utilities, because every utility define the overloading of DT in its own way. And that overloading should be persistent. It should be continuous. So once you know the overloading definition, once you know the peak, once you know the loading of the DT, you can arrive at a size of the BSS you can install to defer that loading. So the sizing was basically divided into two parts. First was preliminary sizing. So we simply obtained the area under the curves, the maximum area under the curve and the maximum area under the curve. So that energy was taken as kilowatt hours, and then the maximum overshoot was taken as kilowatt. Once we know that, we can cater the maximum energy curve through BESS, we also know, then we come to the next part, which is detailed sizing, which looks into whether there is sufficient time to charge a battery and discharge a battery, whether what should be the C rate we should look for. It should be higher, it should be lower, what should be the life, and all those things. This is the basically the BESS control methodology that talks about when BESS should charge and when it should discharge. So the DT which we took had a solar rooftop there. So we first of all obtained the net power by subtracting the solar generation. So when you're talking about the operation of BESS, there are two things which are important. One is SOC, which has to be delivered from the battery. Second is the DT loading. Why DT loading is important? Because you are trying to maintain the loading of DT to a particular level. But this may also happen that your charging of battery can contribute in DT loading again. So that factor should also be taken into account. So the same thing has been demonstrated in this slide, and the charging was higher up to 85% of SOC, and then it reduced because it changed to voltage way of charging. This is basically the cost benefit analysis and the certain assumptions that we took. So when we talk about BSS, we have arrived at a size. We get a component-wise cost from the manufacturer or developer or an integrator. So once we know that cost, so there are two important factors that come into play. One is power cost and one is energy cost. Certain cost of a total battery energy storage system can be divided, can be said as power cost and can be said as energy cost. For example, if I talk about the cost of battery packs, they fall under the category of kilowatt hour cost. And when I talk about power electronics such as inverters, and they fall under certainly under the kilowatt cost. There are certain costs which cannot be divided, but you have to have some rational assumption to divide them in a proportion or maybe on 50-50% basis under the both cost. In this way only you can arrive at a model which will tell you that not only the kilowatt cost will increase your capex, but your kilowatt or cost will also increase your capex by some amount. So the classification of power and energy cost was done. Now the plausible revenue streams were identified. See, first of all, when you are uniformly distributing the load on the DT, you are increasing its life, because it is not having the sudden loads for maybe like 2 hours, 3 hours, whatever the definition of overloading as per the utility. Second thing, you are deferring investments of upgrading that DT. Third thing, if that DT loading matches utility load curve and you are shaving that peak, you are also saving on the peak power purchase of the utility. Though it is not in a significant amount, but yes, it is one of the revenue streams in case the DT curve is matching utility load curve. This becomes very true for the utilities like BRPL, which are mainly residential. So there the all DTs must be having some good amount of correlation, good quantum of correlation factor with the utility load curve. Now, when you have stacked all those benefits, you have taken into account the time value of money, you can actually arrive at CVA. So these are the results, basically, which we want to represent as a part of our CBA. What we found out is a very important factor, which is CAGR. The load growth of that DT is very important when you take a, when you calculate the cost benefit part of BESS, because BESS is actually not a permanent solution to cut up the loading. It is a temporary solution. It can defer the investment. It cannot stop you from investing if load is increasing. So you, if you see there it is done for 5 CAGRs, 1%, 2%, 3%, 4%. And the size which we arrived was 231 kilowatt hour, 157 kilowatt. Actually, it is 231, it's missing. It's not 23, it's 231 kilowatt hour, 157 kilowatt. So for this size, if we look at CAGRs, if load is growing at 4% CAGR, your DT again becomes overloaded at 9th and 10th year. And if load is growing at 5% CAGR, your DT again becomes overloaded at 8th, 9th, 10th year. So CAGR is a very important factor when you're looking to take into account the cost-benefit part of batteries. Now, we have assumed the life of 10 years for this project. But there is a little complication when you track the total number of cycles or throughput, whatever you call it, because that is simply based on the depth of discharge. Whenever you go to a manufacturer or a system integrator, he will tell you that this is the life of your battery based on your this person DOD. But DOD never remains same. So we have also taken into account a model that actually calculates, looking at the particular DOD, that what is the loss in the number of cycles, and we have tried to find out the total number of cycles actually consumed during this control algorithm functioning. And that was coming more than 15 years, but to be on a lower side, we took it 10 years. So if the next column, which is BESS rating, kilowatt hour and kilowatt, this tells you the BESS capacity required to suffice all overload instances for life of 10 years. So the size keeps on increasing with the CAGR of loading. NPV keeps on decreasing. Cost benefit and ratio keeps on decreasing just because the increase in capex is not as much as increase in revenue. At this point of time, the cost of lithium-ion batteries is quite high. So the results I would like to say is BESS is not economically viable for this particular application at these present assumptions. Investment deferral using BESS is a temporary solution, and time to delay in investment in upgrading distribution equipment is directly dependent on load pattern and CAGR of loading equipment. The last slide I'd like to mention that CAGR is important factor that has already come out from this paper. And I'll say that if you are looking at this point of time, BESS as a solution in the distribution utilities, I'll say you should look for utilities which are congested where there is no scope of upgradation. Second thing, their load is saturated so that you can recover your investments. Last, I'll like to thank my utility partners and supporting agencies. Thank you very much.